So I would use 1064 long pulse wavelength in the treatment of dark skin hair removal. You know, if you're going to do a good job in hair removal now, you need to be able to treat all skin types well. And many times people try to get one system and make it work, but 1064 is really the best wavelength for skin type 4, 5, and 6. I also would use it in a fair-skinned person with coarse dark hair.
So in your laser manual, there are settings for laser hair removal for thick hair or thin hair and brown hair versus black hair. Usually with a person's first laser treatment for hair removal, you want to start with the settings for thick hair. And as you move on to subsequent treatments, the hairs that you'll be treating get thinner and thinner, so you'll change your settings to the thinner hair settings. With the thick hair settings, because the thick hair has a larger diameter, you want to use a longer pulse duration so that the energy is delivered over a longer period of time versus a short energy or short pulse duration where you're delivering the energy too quickly. With laser hair removal treatments, you always want to use some kind of cooling. So we have the Zimmer cold air blower connected to our handpiece here so that at the same time of the treatment, there's also cold air blowing onto the skin. And the cooling is for two reasons. One, for patient comfort, but two, more importantly, is to protect the surrounding tissue, in other words, the skin or the epidermis that surrounds the hair follicles that we're treating. So as we do the treatment, I'm gonna cover the entire surface area of the skin that we want to treat. A little bit of overlapping is okay, but generally speaking, overlapping is not necessary. The clinical endpoint to look for with laser hair removal is a little bit of erythema, which we see here, as well as some perifollicular edema, which is just a little bit of swelling directly around the hair follicles, and that's very normal and actually shows a great result. Also, laser hair removal for Fitzpatrick types 4, 5, and 6 can actually be more painful than laser hair removal for Fitzpatrick types 1, 2, or 3, and that's just due to the amount of pigment that's in darker skin colors, and that's very normal as well. So Grant, how does your skin feel after the treatment?
Feels good.
Does it feel warm at all?
A little bit, but not too bad.
Okay, so a little bit of heat sensation, like a mild sunburn, is natural and normal. That usually lasts about 2 to 3 hours and then it should dissipate. If it's bothersome or uncomfortable, you can take some Tylenol or some ibuprofen to help with that. You can also put ice packs on your skin to help with that as well. Your next treatment should be in roughly 6 weeks or so. And then you can also use any of your regular products, for instance, when you shower or wash your face with soap, that's fine. And any aftershaves or lotions that you normally put on your face are totally okay to use as well. But you do want to use a good SPF on your skin for any time you're in the sun for good sun protection after having a laser treatment. Okay, thanks so much for coming in.
Thank you.